Hey guys, what's up? John for Segments here. Welcome to the fourth episode of Ecom Data Cooler Talk, where we talk about important topics in e-commerce and data next to a water cooler. Okay, so today's topic is demand forecasting, and I want to tell you what it is, how it relates to pricing and promotion, and how it can help you plan better. By the way, I'm also going to be at Shopify Unite, and so look me up on Facebook and help me to connect with you there. So let's dive in. So what is demand forecasting? Well, there's two parts to this, demand and forecasting. And so demand, by Wikipedia's definition, is just the amount of a good that a customer is willing to pay at a given price in a given period. And so broadly speaking, it's just what people want, right? And when you look at Tesla Model 3's at its current price, it's forecasted to sell between 370,000 units to 420,000 units this year. And so if you increase the price by 50%, that number is likely to come down by a lot. And how much it comes down by is measured by a metric we call price elasticity, and we can get into that a little bit later. The second part of that is obviously forecasting. It's just trying to predict or estimate a future event based on a set of conditions. And so when you combine these two concepts together, it becomes very powerful because then you can ask questions like, well, how much am I going to sell in the near future? Of course, the true demand of something is unknowable, right? Because you can't survey everyone in the world. Well, Facebook gets kind of close with about a third of the world population, but again, it's unknowable in its nature. Second of all, demand often lacks supply, right? So if I only have 500 t-shirts to sell and I sold out within 30 minutes, well, how do I really know how much true demand there is for the t-shirt, right? But nevertheless, demand forecasting remains a very powerful tool to understand customer behavior around pricing and promotion, and it can help you plan better for holiday events such as BFCM. And let's get into it. So why does demand forecasting matter? Well, as we just discussed, not everyone's going to be aware of your site and your product, but as long as you have your acquisition channel set up, you're sending consistent traffic to your site month over the month. And out of 100 people who visit your site, maybe 60 people bounce right away, 30 people browse around, about 10 people add to cart, and 3 people actually checked out. And so what is demand? And you may say that true demand is really just those 3 people who have paid money in exchange for goods and services, or maybe we consider the 10 people who have add to carts as a potential demand, and maybe they didn't like the prices at the end, or they saw a shipping cost or delivery time was too long, or maybe they just changed their mind or found something better. We don't know for sure, but at least this allows us to a chance to test different prices and promotions and see if we can convert some of that potential demand. And so once you've collected enough information about how your shoppers react to prices and promotions, then you can use that data to start predicting for the future with traffic data and sales data, right? And that becomes a very powerful tool. For example, when you need to negotiate with your suppliers for prices, then you can say, hey, you know, I expect to have this much sales. So that helps you with your planning. It also helps you prevent stockouts during certain key periods, holiday periods in the year where you expect there's going to be a lot of volume. So you want to make sure that you don't leave any money on the table when people have their credit cards out to pay, but there's no goods to sell, right? And lastly, but not least, shorter lead time, right? You can, with proper planning and forecasting, then you can shorten lead time and delivery time for customers and make sure that they're going to be happy, they're going to be able to get their products faster. And you can keep inventory overhead low because you know roughly how much you're going to sell. And so that's very important and a very powerful planning tool. So what can demand forecasting do for me? Well, demand forecasting is not just about predicting sales. It's also understanding your own business as your customers react to your pricing and promotion around your products. For example, is it better to show a $39 sale price marked down from original price of $49, or simply offer a coupon of $10? How much sales are you expecting to get with a 15% off promotion or a 25% off promotion? And when Black Friday comes around, how much inventory should you plan for, right? So these are important questions that can help you drive more sales to your store and understand your business customer behavior. So how do you get started, right? Demand forecasting is typically achieved by using statistical models or machine learning models to explain the effects of pricing, promotion, seasonality, and holiday effects. Now, pricing effects are usually measured by price elasticity. And so this is a ratio of the change in volume divided by the change in price. Like, to give you an example, if
increase
I increase a product by 10% and the volume increases by more than 10%, then we say that the product is elastic because the ratio is bigger than one. And as an example, most consumer goods are elastic products, like toilet paper, right? If it goes on sale, it'll sell more. And on the other hand, most prescription drugs are inelastic products with the price ratio, price elasticity ratio less than one. And so that's like insulin, right? Like even the price is high, you still have to get it if you're a diabetic, right? And so that's a simple explanation of what, you know, a price elasticity is. Now for promotion effects, we really just try to isolate the different types of promotions, whether it's a 10%, 20%, or 50% off promotion, or a different type of offer altogether, like a free shipping offer or buy one, get one free offer, right? You wanna measure those effects as it happen and look at how much change in volume it creates. And seasonality effects are just the cyclical nature of certain sales, and it's usually a reflection of a customer's behavior. Right, you may see that at the beginning of the month, when people have more disposable cash, you know, they're more willing to spend it. And as it gets to later in the month, when bills are due, and then they're, you know, they tighten up their purse, and they're less willing to spend. And so sometimes you see a cyclical nature between months and weeks. Now, lastly, holiday effects are usually represented by really sharp increases of sales volume in a very short period of time. And that usually happens around major holidays in the US, like Black Friday, Christmas, July 4th. And you know, not only are stores really planning a lot of promotions around this time, but consumers are almost trained to expect certain sales to go on and be in a very buying mindset. And so those are usually represented with very sharp increases in volume. So it's very important to measure all these effects in coordination, right? So that we can actually tease out the different effects of each and not muddy the water. Of course, there's always external factors that you can't control for, like macroeconomics, politics, and trade wars and such that affects everyone. But nevertheless, the better you can understand your own pricing and promotion effects, the more likely you'll be able to have a reliable forecast. And so in summary, we talked about what demand forecasting is and how it can help you in planning situations. Understanding and measuring the effects that go into demand forecasting, like pricing and promotion, can help you optimize marketing efforts to your customers. Understanding and measuring the effects of seasonality and holiday can help you prevent stockouts during crucial times of the year. Finally, data is power, and we want to give e-commerce data powers back to the people. So join us today and start growing with your data.